We are an ancient people in our ancestral home, taking care of the landscapes and the ecosystems and the waterways is just good housekeeping for the millennia to come. Our tribe, the Bad River Band, is part of the Lake Superior Chippewa.
We're located in pretty much the center of northern Wisconsin on the beautiful shores of Lake Superior.
People here are friendly, you know, everybody's family around here, everybody kind of knows each other.
Our land base is over 120,000 acres, punctuated by the presence of incredibly rich hydrology.
We are very water rich, around 500 miles of mapped streams and rivers, and a large coastal wetlands complex system, which makes it pretty unique. The Cahkagan and Bad River Sloughs Wetland Complex did get designated as a Ramsar site, or a wetland of international importance. And that was a big deal to us. This system is the first tribal designated Ramsar site.
Here, where the water is very prevalent, it is very important to us. And it was important to our chiefs who selected this place. This is one reservation that we weren't placed on. We chose to be here because it had everything we needed to be able to live a good life.
You know, we live off the land, we hunt, we fish, we gather, and most of that we do on the water, so it's very important to us.
And so in real time, you know, we fight for protection and preservation of our water resources.
And we are so thankful we have a lot of our wetlands intact.
Wetlands are insanely important. We're thinking flooding because those floodplains and the wetlands will absorb some of that runoff water. It also will help filter some of the sedimentation and the erosion that we're seeing with the higher precipitation.
All of these wetlands are unbelievably powerful in different plant medicines that our people have always utilized and depended on.
So we do a lot to protect those wetlands because of different services they provide. We do a lot of monitoring of water chemistry or flow rates, because we need to understand what the current conditions are and what might be affecting the natural resources. Another way we're protecting those really critical floodplain wetlands is not allowing development in those conservation areas. That way they can just be left remote and be able to function the way they need to be functioning.
We pride ourselves as taking care of the land, taking care of our resources. And I think natural resources, the department takes a vital step into ensuring that that's done, helping us as a tribe accomplish that.
One thing that's unique about our Natural Resources Department compared to others is we do utilize both what's called Western science and traditional ecological knowledge, because it's not just about collecting very specific information about water chemistry, but it's also trying to talk to elders and community members to better understand those uses that wetland or water body provide for them.
What I do then is review the project that wants to be done. Then we have to evaluate, how is that going to affect the rice? How will the birds be impacted? How will the bears be impacted? Just like a ripple in a pond, if one is taken out, then it affects everything else around it.
The water, the land, the animals, our people, you know, we're all resources here. So, I mean, we all need to work together as a whole to protect the resources.
We don't know what the future holds for us, so we must remember to take care of what we have here, to always be mindful that it is something that will sustain us in the long run.
We try to keep that seventh generation, those future generations in mind, to send what we have into the future for them, so they're blessed just like we were when we arrived here on this place. And that's a good thing.